Hi guys, welcome back. Today's topic, gas chromatography. We can discuss some important questions from this topic. Please like and subscribe my channel for more updates. First question, what is gas chromatography? It is used to separate volatile components of a mixture without decomposition by differential migration through a column containing liquid or solid state phase. Here, it is also known as vapor phase chromatography, VPC, or gas liquid partition chromatography, as the liquid is usually employed as stationary phase. If solid is used as stationary phase, the technique is referred to as gas solid chromatography, that is GSC. Next question, which type of injector is most commonly used for capillary gas chromatography? Options: purge and trap, splitless injector, split injector, loop injector. Correct answer, option C, split injector. Next question, which is the best match between detectors used in gas chromatography and compounds to which they are sensitive? From the first section, thermal conductivity detector, flame ionization detector, electron capture detector, nitrogen phosphorus detector. Second section, nitrogen and phosphorus containing compounds, all type of species, organic compounds, electron withdrawing species. Correct answer, thermal conductivity matches to all type of species. Flame ionization detector goes option C, organic compounds. Electron capture detector, option D, electron withdrawing species. And the last one, nitrogen phosphorus detector, goes to nitrogen and phosphorus containing compounds. Next one, which of the following is not a common detector for gas chromatography? Options, refractive index detector, flame ionization detector, thermal conductivity detector, mass spectrometer. Correct answer, option A, refractive index detector. Refractive index detector is an HPLC detector. Next question, in gas chromatography, if two solutes with short retention times coelute, coelute means they are not resolved, what is the simplest way to attempt to resolve the PX? Option A, use a longer column temperature. Option B, use a higher column temperature. Option C, use a lower column temperature. Option D, use a more polar solvent. Correct answer, option D, use a lower column temperature. Hint, at lower temperature, elution times are longer. Next, which of the following detectors is commonly used in gas chromatography? Fluorescence, flame ionization, atomic absorbance, all. Correct answer, option B, flame ionization. The most common mobile phases in gas chromatography are hydrogen, nitrogen, and helium. The moving phase or mobile phase is a carrier gas. The stationary phase is a microscopic layer of liquid or polymer often on an inert solid support inside a piece of glass or metal tubing called a column. The instrument used to perform gas chromatography is called a gas chromatograph. In gas chromatography, if a solute is retained too long, it can be made to elute more quickly by using a longer column, using a higher column temperature, using a lower column temperature, using a more polar solvent.
Correct answer option B, using a higher column temperature. Next question. Which of the following detectors in gas chromatography allows for both identification and qualification of a unknown peak in a sample? Options: mass spectrometer, flame ionization, thermal conductivity, sulfur chemiluminescence. Correct answer: mass spectrometer. Next, which are the different types of detectors used in gas chromatography? First one, flame ionization detector. It is mostly suitable for organic compounds. Here, the column effluent containing organic compounds is burned in a small air or hydrogen flame. As a result, various ions like CHO plus ions are formed. These ions create an electrical current that can be detected. The signal is directly proportional to the number of reduced carbons in the column effluent. It is mostly suitable for organic compounds. Next, thermal conductivity detector. Here, it is suitable for all type of analytes. The detector contains two resistors in identical heated chambers, one of which is surrounded by the column effluent gas, the other is surrounded by the identical gas with an identical flow, but it has no passed through the column. When the column effluent contains other molecules, it conducts heat slightly differently, so the resistor has slightly different temperature. This gives the signal that indicates some foreign substance is coming out of the column. Electron capture detector. It is used in the analysis of environmental samples. It is an example of a selective detector. The detector consists of a beta emitter such as nickel 63. The emitted electrons ionize the mobile phase, which is usually nitrogen, resulting in the production of additional electrons that give rise to an electric current between two electrodes. Other detectors include mass spectrometer, FTIR, etc. Electron capture detector is highly selective towards solutes with electronegative functional groups such as halogens and nitro groups, and is relatively insensitive to amines, alcohols and hydrocarbons. It is widely used in the analysis of environmental samples. Next question, what are the advantages of gas chromatography? Fast analysis can be automated, small samples are sufficient, high resolution, non-destructive, highly accurate quantification. Last one, allows online coupling. Example, mass spectrometer. What are the disadvantages of gas chromatography? Limited to volatile samples, temperature of column is usually limited to 380 degrees Celsius. Analyte should have boiling point below 500 degrees, not android by mistake. Next one, not suitable for thermally labile samples. Samples must be soluble and do not react with the column. Requires spectroscopy to confirm the peak identity. And the last one, slow injection of large sample result in decreased resolution. I hope you like this video. For more suggestions and doubts, you can drop a comment in comment box. Thank you for watching.